Dante on the beat, nigga.
That bullshit, right? On that bullshit. Full clips, if you back on that bullshit. On that bullshit. We back on that bullshit.
Oh, so Liam Hamill is back. Liam, hey, we've called a bunch of his fights.
We have.
You want to talk about a tornado in the cage?
Yes, my man. Is Matt here?
Oh, you know Matt's here.
He's got to be. Yeah. But last time I cornered him, I got to talk to Matt. I said, Matt, when you fought Michael Bisping, you won. You were robbed.
And I remember that.
He responded, oh, you remember that? I said, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, we all do.
It turned me off Bisping for decades.
And really, Matt can say he's the only dude that's beat John Jones.
He beat him.
But yeah, so when I saw Liam was on here, I was excited about that. I knew me and you loved calling his fights.
Yeah.
Also, this Kestin guy, man. This guy is 10-3 as an amateur.
Wow.
This will be his 14th amateur fight. It's like, I told him last time, I was like, bro, it's time to go pro, man. You've seen everything in the amateur level. He says if he wins this belt, he's going.
Okay. All right.
He's got a tough fight.
Tough fight, get that belt.
Liam Hamill's no joke.
Now, 14 and 10 and 3, 14. Yeah. How big a win streak is he on? Do we know?
Yeah, he's on a 5-fight win streak.
Oh, yeah,
The last time he fought Future Fighting, beat a really tough guy, finished him in the second round.
Okay,
TKO. Now she blew out like sweat's dangerous. 40 on my side, decorate niggas like a paintbrush. Money, power, respect, dog, I swear I never change her. Switch up for what? I stay right around with real niggas. Glocks on them long flips, and they like to kill niggas. What up, catch a body. 6-fight win streak. I said 5.
Six fights.
All of them but one finishes.
Okay.
So he's a finisher. I mean, it's hard. You usually don't see an amateur that has a 10-3 record.
Yeah, not
usually
often.
After the 10th fight, you're going pro.
Going to pro, making a little bit of money. A real little bit.
He just said that he's young, and he's like, man, I fight all the time, and I'm just trying. He goes, when I turn pro, everything's calculated. Right. Everything matters. Right now, it means nothing.
Yeah,
besides experience.
You can go out there with the intent to lose, but do what you want to do in that fight. I'm spinning heel kicking this time. See what happens.
Yeah.
You play with
it? That dude wanted to try the darts. Russ wanted to try the darts the whole night. He told me and you he's going to win by darts. Try it, bro. It didn't work for you. You need to get back to the gym and work that technique.
Yeah.
But he was almost there. It's just that small minute step.
Just a little bit will change everything. Won't rest till I see your casket in the dirt. All you niggas do is act like you be acting with the perp. Check my page, bitch. We acting up with the perp. And I really shoot shit. You can ask my nigga perp. Niggas call the cops.
Folks at home, this is Liam Hamill, his uncle.
The Hammer
is the famous Hammer.
I got
Matt Hamill, Olympian, deaf Olympian.
I didn't realize he was in the Olympics.
Nice, yes,
you wrestled in the Olympics?
He did.
Oh, that's awesome. Makes me like him even more.
Yeah, the only deaf athlete, the first ever deaf athlete in the UFC.
Okay. Is there another one?
No. He was the only. He's the first and the
first
only.
Yeah, okay.
That I know of. I don't think there's been another one.
Yeah.
There's been
only man alive who's beaten John Jones.
Only been one deaf guy in the octagon. There's been a few with only one eye. So.
Yeah, it's Bisping and who's that new guy? The Bullet.
Yeah. This is going to be a good fight. People at home, I'm telling you guys, both of these guys are seasoned. They look great. I don't see Matt Hamill.
I don't.
We know Liam's going to come out. He's not going to fill out nothing. He's coming balls to the wall. Bottom line.
You going to say maybe he slept through his alarm? I'm sorry, Matt. You deserve to beat me up.
woke up in the world and cut the lights off. And confidence is a stain they can't wipe off.
He beat up my teammate Terry Sofagio, and I was so upset. Like, oh, Terry. And I thought it was a fight Terry was going to win, and Matt Hamill just came out and brought it to him.
And Sofagio was, man, you're talking about tree trunks for legs? Sofagio was huge, man.
Yeah.
And I really liked the way Sofagio fought. Seems like he was always just on the losing end a lot of times. But he's so good.
He's the one if every fight he fought was in the gym, he'd be undefeated.
He would crush
anyone. In the cage, he did pretty well, but in the practice ring, he would beat anyone. I don't know that I've ever won a round against him.
Isn't that crazy how that works out? And I'm saying this not being funny, but you have gym heroes like that.
Oh, yeah.
And then they come out here and they just cannot put it all together. On the big fights, they just can't put it together on the big fights.
So I see that Kiston's got on UFC shorts. I noticed Gates had on Dylan Bucca's UFC shorts.
Okay.
I just noticed that earlier after the fight.
Right.
I feel like... I feel like that you should never put a belt on if you're not the champion. I believe in bad mojo, right? I don't think you should wear UFC shorts if you've never been in the UFC. It's just my opinion.
Personally, because to buy them, they're like $75.
That's what I was just about to say, man. They're expensive.
Yeah.
I do like Venom stuff. It is nice.
Yeah, I like their fight gear. I don't like their other gear. Their other gear, their boxing gloves and shin guards are perfect.
Yeah.
But their pants and stuff, they're European company, so everything fits too tight.
Ooh, nice inside.
Yeah. Came through him out with the jab.
Man, you know, Hamill's really not coming out crazy like he usually does. I like that. I like to see him grow like that.
Yeah.
More patience, right? Nice little jab right there.
So by MMA math, he's actually beating John Jones too.
Well, yeah, I guess that's so. True. I mean, you're right.
Hey, he must have submitted his uncle at some point.
Oh, McClain's backing up.
Good foot movement.
Oh, no, big right hand.
Yeah, McClain looks sharp. He's straight down the middle from the face, going back to the face.
And what I love about McClain, he might come straight back, but he cuts the corner.
Yeah.
He cuts the corner, he gets off the table, which is beautiful. He gets out of the zone. And we were talking about this earlier, how the front leg needs to be on the outside. If you watch McClain, his front leg is on the outside of the limbs most of the time.
Yep. He's playing it perfectly. Then just enough movement to make anything
nice left hand.
A little off center.
That left hand is just barely missing. Straight down the pipe.
So you said he's young. How old is he, McClain?
27.
Okay. Yeah, he's still got time. Especially the way the UFC works now is that you get 4-0 and they'll start looking at you.
100%. Let me make sure. I think he is 27.
Yeah, he's moving well.
Oh, man, I'm so sorry, Mr. McClain. Man's 24 years old.
Okay.
That's even better.
Even younger.
Even younger. At 10, he's already got 14 fights.
Yeah.
That's crazy, right? That's what I was talking about. This kid began at 17 years old, man.
Yeah, when I first started fighting, I went 6-1 as a 6-1 as an amateur. And I did it all in about 4 months, and then I turned pro. I fought pro, and then I started training.
But back then, you could get away with it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you couldn't do it now.
No. I mean, Sam, well, you're in a different sport. I say it is a different sport. But, you know, MMA, don't you feel like you have to be legit at everything? Now, can you get away with things? Yes, you can. But I feel like to be like a Sean Strickland. Sean Strickland, people don't realize, Sean Strickland is awesome in jiu-jitsu.
Oh, yeah.
People don't know that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But he is. He just hates it.
He's got to be a second degree at this point.
Yeah, I think he is. I think he said he got his black belt like 10 years ago.
Something like that. I was there when he got it.
Yeah. He's one of my favorite. I love that guy, man.
Oh, he's great. He's wonderful.
I love it.
I'm going out to train with him here in about a week or so.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm going to finish my camp out there. It's hard to find guys my size. I think it was a close round, but I think I would give it to Leo. He was just a little more active, laying a little bit more.
It's very close, though.
Yeah, it was.
One or two strikes.
Yeah. Yeah. McClain looked sharper. Like, he was moving well.
He was more on his heels, yeah.
A little out of range the whole time. So we'll see if he turns it up this round. But Liam looked great. Like you said, he did not come out crazy. He came out controlled.
It looks like I saw Jeremy Pender over there in the corner of Liam Hamill. Love Jeremy Pender. He was B2 champ for a long time.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Straight veteran, a straight dog, and he's never had the respect that he deserves. I feel like he should be fighting in a bigger promotion.
I like that little movement McClain's
got. I do, too.
He's looking good. Little bob and weave to his head. Coming in, sticking the jabs, feinting some kicks.
Woo! Boom, nice little over the top on the right hand. Just over the left arm of Liam Hamill.
Those kicks are working. Like, that more landing than not. It's enough to throw McClain off.
Man, the thing is, I just cannot believe how composed Hamill is. It's so great to see this. I've never seen him this composed, ever, in his fights. The cage looks really dark, like there's a lot of shadows in that cage. Do you think that plays a factor in your vision, like for head kicks or any kind of side strikes, as in hooks?
Maybe it does, but I guess I don't know.
Like in that corner it's real dark. It could just be the screen here, but it does look like it. But I mean, both of these guys got good footwork, man.
Yeah, they're both doing real well. They're both landing. They're both in and out. None of them are taking a significant amount of damage.
I mean, if you want to nitpick, you could say, you know, Hamble's ducking his elbows a little bit, but people fight that way these days, man. They fight up with their ribs exposed.
Well, shoot that.
Oh, Sean, nice. Beautiful leg kick right there.
Sean Strickland never has his hands by his face. He keeps one under his chin.
Yeah, there's not a lot of Sean Stricklands in this world.
And nobody touches them. Well, I'm going to touch him here in a few weeks.
There you go.
Yeah. Keep your hands up, Sean. I'm coming for you. Please, nobody tell me I said that.
I'm not going to say anything because my luck, he rented this pay-per-view for some odd reason. But really, I mean,
ooh, there's a big
cross.
That
was a huge big cross right there.
Got 15 seconds left. It's a close round. That cross might have given him the round.
We were talking to the refs during intermission. They couldn't believe how good the fights have been tonight. Man, we're enjoying reffing these fights.
Yeah, we got to give Hard Rock props.
Yeah, 100%.
Now step behind, pull that leg out. Oh, he's doing it. He was. You got to change that level as you're doing it. Oh, there's the takedown. Wow.
Beautiful job. See, on this closed guard, if you're not going for submissions, I wouldn't have a closed guard. I would be open, butterfly, feet on the hips, trying to get the heck out of this position, right?
How long are these rounds?
There's supposed to be three rounds. So this fight is 5 3-minute rounds. It's a title fight.
Hey, okay, I'm just looking at the screen and the time's not right. So, I mean,
do they have 5 minutes?
I don't know what they're doing.
So like the next two.
The time is still going right now.
Yeah, they're off.
Okay.
TV's off. Well, and get your ass
blue black, my nigga, my nerve.
Round three.
So 5 3 minutes. Okay.
I've got two rounds for Liam. Rob's being real close, but I give that one to him a little more solidly. Because of the takedown.
Give a fuck, nigga. What that weed? Landing like a privacy.
I think we're taking a step backwards with the music.
I believe so, yeah. Is the DJ getting tired? He didn't work his cardio before the event, man.
So you're saying that Hamill has eked out the first two rounds. I agree with you, Sam.
I think he eked out the first round. I think he won the second.
Okay, there you go. That's fair enough. What do you think McClain's got to do, man?
He just needs higher volume. He needs to land.
There you go.
He's getting a little too comfortable defending everything. Because nothing clean is really landing. But McClain's not landing anything but that one, I think it was a cross in round two.
Yeah, he landed flush on that cross, but that was it.
Yeah. If you get up the volume a little bit, maybe kick back. I don't know if I'd threaten a takedown. Not against Liam, but just get a little more. See, the feints are beautiful. Take advantage of those feints.
But you've got to do something with them.
Yeah, and that's you throw that feint, you come in with that overhand. You come in with that jab. Start launching some kicks at the head. Like stylistically, he's doing everything perfect.
He
look, hands are up. He's moving great. He's keeping. He's fainting. He's doing it well. He's just not capitalizing on his good moments. Like there's a good kick. Maybe follow it up with something else. Push Liam back a little bit.
There. Just not enough output.
Yeah.
Oh, Hamill. Oh, there he comes. Beautiful entry for Hamill. He's got to suck them hips out. There he goes.
Now, does McClain usually fight at this weight, at 170?
No, he. The last couple of ones have been at 55.
Okay, that's what I would have guessed.
As you can tell.
Yeah.
Like he, very undersized, I feel like, for 70.
Yeah.
I mean, hell, man, today's age, these 70s are huge guys. They're walking around at 200 pounds.
Sean Strickland was 210 cutting to 170.
That's stupid. And he's a big man. Look at, I mean, Hamill is fighting a true veteran and he's doing really well. I just feel like McClain's just a step behind.
I had a teammate who said he never wanted to fight for a title. So I don't want to do five rounds. I said, okay, well, all right. He meant it. He like turned down title shots. Like not bored enough for me.
I see his logic though. Yeah, I get it. I mean, man, if I'm not getting paid, I'm fighting. Big arm bar. The elbow's in. That's deep. He's going to break his arm. That just sunk it in deeper.
Oh, he did.
That was huge. That was deep.
Yeah, he snuck that in.
Yeah, he did. That was slick.
Yeah.
Slick armbar.
Beautiful.
And your new 170 amateur welterweight champion, Kestin McClain, man.
Beautiful fight. Beautiful
job. Hey, like you said, he looked good on everything. Just wasn't dialing it together.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden, that sneaky armbar, man. And Liam should have stacked, not tried to pull up and stack. And stacking.
If you're going to slam someone, you got to get them up over your waist. You got to get them over your waist. Under your waist, it's not going to do anything to them.
I think if he would have stacked him, gave him the business, but that was in. That elbow was so deep in.
Yeah.
So past the thighs, you know.
I've got a buddy, and when he does anytime he's armbar, you're like, he'll bait the armbar just so he can put a shin on my face. I said, okay, you win. You can have your arm back. You rotten kid. And now he's on a seven fight win streak.
Woo! 6 finishes, 1 decision. I see a guy, if he turns pro, that would give him a really good run in his pro debut sitting right beside us. Oh, Ethan Riley was supposed to fight in our co-main event.